Hello guys, this is Mac here, back in the new video. Today we will start our completely new series which will be based on signal processing. In this series, we will implement some of the basic concepts of signal processing using MATLAB and we will see how we can solve it using MATLAB and we will plot the graph for it also. Okay, in our previous series, we have solved some numerical fundamentals using MATLAB and we build some fundamental background on the numerical computation so that while we will solve our signal processing problem, we will not have any problem regarding mathematics. Okay, so hope you enjoy that series. If you didn't watch till now that series, go and watch that video and come again towards the signal processing concept. So in this series, in our first video, I will be just implementing some basic signals which are present in signal processing, just like we will first implement today the continuous time signal and tomorrow we will go for discrete time signals. Okay, so I have taken some basic signals that are present. Some basic signal we know that are first is unit step signal, unit impulse signal, RAM signal, exponential signal, that is e to the power x and a to the power x, and another is sinusoidal signal, and we will see how we can plot it using MATLAB and how we can program it using MATLAB. So let's switch to MATLAB and see how we can program these signals using MATLAB. These are very simple. Before moving to the complicated problem and some advanced concept, we have to first analyze the basic signals. We will be using these signals in our further videos, so please stay tuned and watch very carefully and please practice with me always. Okay. Let's switch to MATLAB. And our first signal is unit step signal. Everyone knows what is unit step signal. Unit step signal is nothing but UT for continuous time signal. For t greater than or equal to 0, the value of the signal will be 1, and for t less than 0, the value will be 0. That means for t less than 0, it should 0, and when it comes at t equal to 1 to infinity, that means it switches to 1. That's why it's a unit step. It takes step at 0 and goes to infinity. Okay. Now let's see how we can plot it using MATLAB, how we can program it. First CLC for closing the all the now we understand what is unit step signal and now we will plot it using, you can program it using MATLAB. Okay, we will take some range of values. Okay, suppose I am taking for step will be 0.01. I am taking for minus 10 to 10, range will be minus 10 to 10. Okay, our graph range will be minus 10 to 10 x-axis, and step will be 0.01. For each step it will take 0.01. suppose n equal to length of n, n will store the length of t. Okay, now we will derive a condition that will plot for I equal to 1 to n, and we will see if ti, that means the value of ti, that means t of 0, t of 1, t of I barabar, I equal to 1 to n, that means okay, I will be equal from 1 to n because the indexing start from 1 in MATLAB. Okay, then we will see if t of I, that means t of 1, t of 2, t of 3 will be greater than or equal to 0. Okay, if the indexing value t of I on x-axis will be greater than or equal to 0, then we will see u of I, what it will be 1. Okay, now else we will say u of I will be what, 0. Okay, and we will end here. Okay, this is your condition to plot the unit step signal. For t of I greater than or equal to 0, u of I should be 1, and for less than 0, it should be 0. Okay, now before moving that, let's plot first. We will plot it on t, comma u. Let's see if it is giving the correct answer what we are expecting. Yeah, this is the graph. You can see in the graph that the value before 0 is 0, and when it comes to 0, it switches to 1 directly. Okay, for greater than 0 the value is 1, and for less than 0 the value is 0. Okay, now we will give some labels also. X label, we will say it's the amplitude axis, and y label time axis, and we will give title to it, and we will say its title is unit step signal. Unit step signal. Now let's run it and see what it is giving. Okay. Yes, if you will look to the graph, it is giving time. Okay, look to the graph. Its title is unit step signal. Its amplitude axis on y axis, and on x axis it is time axis. Okay, so we have seen and we have analyzed that for unit step signal we can implement it using MATLAB in this way. Okay, now our next problem is to implement a unit impulse signal. What is unit impulse signal? Unit step signal, that means it should take a step after with a from 0. It should take a step from 0, and it from 0 the value should be 1 only. Okay, now for the unit impulse signal, that means the impulse value will be 1 at 0. That means the value will 0 everywhere on the axis, but the value will be there at 0. That means at 0 equal to t equal to 0, the value of y should be 1. Okay, I think it's clear. Now let's implement it. We have to only change this condition. Okay, now we will see, say if t of I will be equal to 0, if ti will be 0, then we will say ui only, we will not change the variable. It should 1. Okay. Else we will say u of I will be 0. Okay, now let's plot it and see what it is giving. It should give 1 at 0 and 0 elsewhere. At least one end is missing, sorry. Right hand false, it is missing. Yeah, net is little bit slow, please bear with me. Okay. Yeah. We can see in the graph the value is 0 everywhere, because we are taking range from minus 10 to 10. You can take your range only, and I have to show only that the value at 0 is equal to 1 as our condition given. Okay, now we will change our unit title also. Okay, that's true. Very simple to plot. Only we have to give only condition. If we will know the concept, then it is very easy to plot in MATLAB. Okay, ओनली यू शुड नो बेसिक ऑफ प्रोग्रामिंग, हाउ यू कैन गिव द कंडीशन, लूपिंग, फॉर लूप एंड ऑल दोज थिंग्स. ओके नाउ सी, यूनिटी पल्स सिग्नल इज द टाइटल, एम्पलीट्यूड एक्सिस इन वाई एक्सिस एंड ऑन एक्स एक्सिस इट्स अ टाइम एक्सिस. ओके नाउ आई थिंक क्लियर. नाउ वी हैव अनदर टाइप ऑफ सिग्नल, बेसिक सिग्नल, दैट इज रैम्प सिग्नल. रैम सिग्नल दैट मीन्स यू एवरी वन नो रैम सिग्नल इज वॉट. दैट मीन्स इफ वी कैन से यू टी इक्वल टू टी, टी इज अ रैम्प. दैट मीन्स इफ वाई इक्वल टू एक्स, दैट्स ऑल्सो अ रैम्प सिग्नल. ओके ओके नाउ वी विल प्लॉट अवर नेक्स्ट सिग्नल, दैट इज रैम्प सिग्नल. एवरीथिंग विल बी सेम, ओनली वी हैव टू रिमूव द कंडीशन. A ramp signal is what? Let's see here. Y, we said y equal to x. That means this is ramp signal. Okay. Now let's plot this signal. Only we have to change the condition. We will say u of I at every value of u of I, u of 0, u of 1, it should be t of I. It should take the value of t at each index. Okay. Now this is the ramp signal. Okay. This is the ramp signal. You can see in the graph. This plotted by me. Okay. Let it run. Yeah. Okay. These are all values at each indexing. For each row and column, it is taking the values. It will plot it right now. Yeah, it's completed. Now it will plot it. Yes, you can see in the graph. It is a ramp signal. Okay, it is just like a y equal to x type of graph. Now we will remove its name and we will say it's a ramp signal. Okay. Okay, let me do it here. Because it will fill all the command window. Okay. Yeah, this is the RAM signal. You can just change the title label also. That doesn't matter. Title and that thing, that's to see only, for others only. The matter is what condition you are giving to plot the signal. If you will change the condition, then signal will be changed. Okay, now we will move for our next problem, and that is to implement an exponential signal. Okay, now we will see how we can implement exponential signal using MATLAB. Exponential, that means what? E to the power x. Now we will see how we can plot it using MATLAB. Everything will be same, just we have to change the condition only. Now we will say it's our exponential signal. It's an exponential signal. Now, just to plot RAM signal, we have given here t of I. Now we will not give t of I. Else, we will plot exponential of t of I. Now, I think it should plot for us. Let's see if it can plot for us. If I am moving very fast, then you can. Yeah, that is an exponential signal. You can see it is exponentially increasing. Okay, yeah, from here, from all the range, from minus 10 to 10, you can see it is exponentially increasing. Now another type of an exponential signal is also that it should a to the power f. That means a, if any constant to the power something. Okay, now to change this, we will take a value of a. Now we will say it a to the power something, a to the power t of I. Now I will define a equal to 9. Okay, let's see what value it is giving for us. We are deriving here 9 to the power something and we will plot it. Yeah, this is also exponential signal for us, but this is in the form of a to the power x, and in previous one we solved for e to the power x. Okay, ओके, नाउ आई थिंक इट इज़ वेरी क्लियर हाउ यू कैन प्लॉट डिफरेंट सिग्नल यूजिंग मैटलैब ओनली। ओके, नाउ वी विल मूव फॉर नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम एंड आवर नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज व्हाट, लेट मी सी लिटिल बिट। या वी प्लॉट यूनिट स्टेप, यूनिट इंपल्स, रैंप, एक्सपोनेंशियल, ई टू द पावर एक्स एंड ए टू, एंड दैट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सिग्नल, इंपॉर्टेंट सिग्नल वी यूज इन आवर सिग्नल प्रोसेसिंग, दैट इज साइनोसॉइडल सिग्नल। ओके, साइनोसॉइडल सिग्नल इज व्हाट वी यूज टू राइट y equal to a sin omega t, okay, a sin omega t, where omega we used to write 2 pi f t, okay, I can write it here, sin omega into t, sin omega into t, okay, yeah, I'm just explaining you, I'm not doing anything here, where omega is 2 into pi into f into t. Very simple, and we have to plot this signal only, then we will remove everything from here. Yeah, even we don't need the length. Okay, range will be same and label will be same, and we will say it here, sinusoidal signal, we will plot it also, range will be same for us. Okay, range will be same for us, we will plot it in a different manner, because every time suppose our sampling frequency will be, you know everyone, the sampling frequency at each sample per second, we take sampling frequency 8 kilohertz. Okay, now sampling for time we should take 1 by fs, that means second per sample. Fs is sample per second and t is sample per second. Okay, now we will define for stop time also. We will define our stop time for this signal. That means let's say 0.25. That means 25 kilohertz. Sorry, 25, not kilohertz, that is time. 25 millisecond. Now we will define range in different manner here. Suppose our range will start from 0, there we were taking from minus 10 to 10, here we will take from 0 to t, our step will be 1 by 8000. Okay, 1 to t, and our last will be stop time minus t, let's say stop time minus t. Okay, this is our stop time. Now suppose we have defined a sampling frequency, now we will define a carrier frequency also. For carrier frequency, suppose we are taking 60 hertz, we are taking 60 hertz. Now we will say sine or cos, we can plot it. Suppose we are plotting for cos only, and we will say 2 pi carrier frequency into t, because in amplitude modulation we used to take normally cos, so that's why I am taking cosine. Okay, so we will plot t comma x. Suppose we are defining figure, now we will say zoom. Now let's see if it is plotting for us or not. Okay, let's see. It is plotting for us. It is giving a sinusoidal signal. We can avoid the warning and error here, because I am using online MATLAB, so maybe some internal issue, but we are getting our graph. For which we have defined sampling frequency 8000, stop time this, and carrier frequency 60 hertz. Then we plot for cos 2 pi f ct, and it is giving us a graph of cos. Okay, now if we want to zoom it, I have given zoom x on, we can zoom it also, we can make it little bit. Okay, now let me plot for cosine also. we have plotted for cos. Now I have to plot it for sine. Now let's see if it is giving for sine. Okay. Yeah, this is the sine for, because it is you starting from zero. You can see it here. Let me zoom it little bit. Yeah, this is the sinusoidal graph. You can plot it. Yeah, you can plot it in your window. I am using online MATLAB, so it is very, yeah, this is the sine graph. I think this is very clear. We have plotted six basic signals that are used in signal processing, and we have seen how we can plot it and how we can program it using MATLAB given on condition. Okay, we have seen how we can, we are seeing here how we can give different labels, titles, how we can use zoom command, and we have plotted here on different windows. Okay, now tomorrow what I will tell in using, we will plot it every six graphs in single window only. Okay, using subplots. Okay, and this is plotting, we are plotting here only continuous time signal, and tomorrow we will plot it for discrete time signal, and after that we will move for some basic concepts of signal processing such as filtering, Jet transform, Laplace transform. Okay, the basic concept we will move, and we will go very slowly. Thanks for watching the video. Please subscribe the channel for stay tuned, and subscribe my channel, share my channel, and please watch previous tutorial. That will be very helpful. The mathematical computation will be very helpful in signal processing concept. Thanks.